Hello all and welcome. It is me. I am the Prehistoric Master. Welcome to my walkthrough of Dark Souls 3. We are going to be starting all brand new. And let's let this
indeed
the intro begin.
It is called Lothric, where the transitory lands of the Lords of Cinder converge. In venturing north, the pilgrims discover the truth of the old words.
Fire fades.
And the lords go without thrones. Saint of the Deep. Farron's undead legion, the Abyss watches. Lord of the profaned capital. Yon the giant. Only in truth, the lords will abandon their thrones. Nameless, accursed, undead, unfit even to be cinder. And so it is that ash seeketh embers.
So guys, let's make our character then, shall we? We'll go for a male. What should we name our character? And do. We'll name it Mass. Go for a mature knight. What class? We'll go for the warrior. Our burial gift, we shall go for. We'll go for the life ring just to get that little bit more health. I aren't really bothered about this. Um, go for Lador, Shadow of the Death. Nope. Go for a little bit like that. Alright, let's get into this. I am looking very, very forward. I will most probably die so many times because I do struggle at some bits, but I do know basically what I'm doing. This isn't going to be an expert walkthrough like most people do on YouTube, but I'll try my best to entertain. And the opening gives me goosebumps. Just, especially when you see Yorm Ember up. And now embers are what have replaced the humanity and the human effigies in the past two games. So they're gonna be, you can buy them, but they're not very common. So you have to save them. And here I come, arise. Now here we are in the cemetery of Arsh. Now we've got our Estus Flask. Shield. That's the parry animation. Alright, that's okay. Alright, I didn't mean to do that. I don't want to do that. I'm trying to get used to these controls. I've just got to realign our stuff. Yeah, so it's teaching us the regular attacks. So a strong attack. We'll target this. Alright, he goes down. Backstep. Backstep. And use the L3 to move. Ah, there we go. You hold it. I think this is some souls right here. Yes, souls of the priest's corpse. Now, when I did this game on my own, I went for the knight. So I had a bit more armor to go with, but never mind. Aha, there we are, the Ashen Estus Flask. This basically gives us more magic. Now you see this guy here, no matter what you do, he is deaf. So if we lock on, we can do a good parry animation. And that's what you would see a backstab. So, just to let you know, I didn't even know that until a few days ago, that he's deaf no matter what. Yeah. Barry. And that's a repost right after. Oh, that's my first ever parry. You saw it here first, guys. Yay! Feels so good. Well, that's a L1. Ah, I've never been able to do them, so never mind. Take care of that. Yes, let's do our two-handed. Whoa! He went. Our battle cry gives a bit of a boost of extra attack. That's why you see we're glowing. Boosted melee. Okay, you see that turn back here? I suggest listening. If you are not prepared to basically face a giant crystal lizard, but I am the master here. So this guy will bow down to my inferiority. You can actually riposte this guy, but it is extremely difficult, because sometimes you have to stagger him. Oh, I thought I had him then. But that does. I'm gonna move away. Drink an Estus flask. Here we go. Right in the mouth. I will get a titanite shard. Now that is used for upgrading. I can't remember what this upgrade is. Upgrades crystal stuff, I think. For like your crystal weapons. I know there's another soul item here somewhere, I think. Oh no, that's the other one. Never mind. Now, if you do see me go quiet at some time, guys, that is when I am trying to concentrate. Now I do have to apologise for not doing anything in a few months because I was at work, so I had to do all that, so of course I had no choice. But I did get money. That is basically just tells us how you can toggle between stuff, so. But we don't have anything at the top, so I think at the top's where like your spells and stuff goes. I think, or is that at the bottom? I can't really remember. But let's look at the view. It looks absolutely beautiful. I see that is our target over there. That is known as Firelink Shrine. In this episode, all we're going to do is basically get to Firelink Shrine, beat the tutorial boss, and basically talk to all the NPCs in the next episode, which I'm going to do right after this, will be the High Wall of Lothric, if I remember correctly. Now, let's light the bonfire. We'll rest it. There we go, we've got our rest emoji. Now how do I do these? Ah, here we go. We have... we'll bow. Let's go. Now, yes, you see I've got quite a few souls. Pretty sure there's someone here, isn't there? Yeah, right there. There we go. Went down. I didn't expect to lose health. I am a bit rusty, guys, so I do apologize. I'm not used to something having the delays. I would love one of them swords, but since we're a warrior. Yeah, actually, it's just not worth it just to rest in, because we'll need our rest as flags. But it is a good way to get them souls. There we go, never riposte. I parried you once again, you fool. Bow down to the master. See, this is a way to go to grind on souls from the beginning. Yep, as you see, it's a good way to grind souls very early on. Now, we're about to learn how to do a lunge attack. So I think it's this one here. No, it's after. But here, we're gonna do something. If we get here, I can't remember what it is, you'll get a titanite shard. This is where we're learning about. Yes, plunging. What you gotta do, make sure you target it, fall, and hold R1. There we go. And you get a bit more souls because you've done something. Nothing else here. Now ready. Now guys. None of that. We'll go down in the ground. Alright, we'll put this away so I can get a boost in attack. As soon as you take out the actual sword, you can start doing stuff. But just look at this, guys. It's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. We'll charge up. Move the sword. Alright, we'll do this, and as you see, he is an... Oh, I forgot to pick up something. Death bad. As you see, he does go down quite easy. But we've got more strength. So just going for one. Oh, I missed. Yep, here we go. This is the decor. Oh, we just got a... Oh, no. Drink up. So you just take it nice and easy. It's pretty easy because it's only a tutorial boss. I can't believe I missed all that. As you see, there we go. Where's the first boss done? Now. I'm going to go collect something, and when you're embered, you get full of health. You basically get, I think it's an extra 25%. Oh yeah, too sure. But this is what I wanted to get. Oh, he dropped an item. Oh, so. Faded souls. I wanted to get these fire bombs, which are really good on him. And there's some more fading souls. Now, my good friend who actually created my banner art, when you will see it soon, he's creating his as well, so stay tuned. But it will have my new name and everything. And I will leave a link his channel in the description once he's got it all up and running, because he's going to be doing all games on PC. But never mind, and our latest version is installed, so that's good. Now this area does have something later on in the game, but some of the bosses in here are so cool. And the lore in this is so hard to understand. Who we got into is our head. And I don't know how our guy can open this door. Must have some bloody goddamn muscles on him. Broken straight sword. Yep, we'll just use that to open the menu, but we're not too bothered about that. Yes, got the fading souls. Now they only give you about 50 souls, but they're still good at the beginning. There we go, Homeward Bone. That'll take us back to our... Well, you can choose, actually. The Last Bonfire or Firelink Shrine. Now, we won't really be using a lot of magic. I'm just going to try and go for some strength. Because you need lots and lots of strength. Where the... God's sake. More fading souls. But this area is absolutely beautiful, guys. Just look at the views. There is a weapon that we can get, but it's quite hard to get off the guy. But it's a sub. Yes, dogs. Now, dogs are really weak to fire damage, so that is quite good. And an ember. That is, well, when you're embered, it means you can actually go online. And you, so you can, you're immune, you're actually getting invaders. So we won't really be doing a lot of them. Here we are, Firelink Shrine. Now, what we're going to basically do, we're just going to talk to everyone. Let's talk.
Welcome to the bonfire, unkindled one. I am a fire keeper. I tend to the flame and tend to thee. The lords have left their thrones and must be delivered to them. To this end, I am at thy side.
Now we will level up very soon.
To be unkindled is to be a vessel for souls.
Basically, all she reads is, more souls we get, while we can get strong. Now, let's put this in. And this is our hub. But, now remember the top thing is for, we don't have any bone shards. And we'll travel very, very soon. But let's use select. Here we go. And get some levels of these. Now we'll just check if we have any more. But I don't think so. No, we don't. Right. We'll level up very soon, but let's go talk to these other people. Now this, she's not unkindled, she's just undead. A completely different. But really, she's a pain in the ass. And that is the opponent of Dark Souls laughing. Now we'll keep these. We need them. These sell for free souls. That's basically it. Let's see what she has. Embers. We'll buy the embers. Heal aid. I don't think I can actually. Actually, no, I can't. When it has the red X, it means you've got insufficient souls and what else? Something else, but. That's the, if you was playing as the Prav, that would be how you would pick up. Don't think it's really any good.
Ashen one.
Ah, shut up, you.
Ashen Purdue the Moktolop.
Yes,
well.
Yes.
Then touch taken. Ashen Purdue the Moktolop. Very well. Then touch the darkness within me.
Okay, let me do it then.
Take nourishment from these sovereignless souls. Farewell, Ashen One.
It's not because we're there, is it?
Ashen, the Moktolop. Very well, then take.
Here we go. Achievement. Now, if you listen, she is actually doing an incantation. Luck improves our item discovery, so we can level up once. Now, what do we want to do? Our strength's already fine as it is. Vitality's our equipment loading. But how our health? Let's put some health up. Can't do any more.
Farewell, Ashen One. May the flames guide thee.
We're pretty sure. Yep, they've got our life rings already on. Only increases it like the tiniest little bit. There's no one else here except, if any Dark Souls fans out there, then you know this. Well, he is from the very, very first Dark Souls, says the blacksmith. He will reinforce our ashen flags. We can choose if we want 4 or 3, but we'll keep it as it is. We can't do anything, so we need Titanite Shard. I'll just have a look, just to double check if there isn't anything. I'm pretty sure no one else is here. No, well, actually, no. No one at the back, but this guy's a whole quest, lad. Sure, there's the Firekeeper, but I can't remember how you do that, so I'll just do my best.
Another one roused from the...
Will you give me con- and it would...
Yes, he gives you collapse.
What a ask you to.
Now, if I switch, we'll get rid of Joy, so we switch. We have rest and collapse. Yeah. We done. Now, there's someone over there, I bet you're wondering, who is he? He is one of the Lords of Cinders. But you do not have to actually verse him, which I do don't like, but he is quite a good person.
All unkindled, and a seeker of lords. I am Ludlith of Corland. Look not in bewilderment as I say. I linked the fire long ago, becoming the Lord of Cinder. If substantiation be thy want, set thine eyes upon my charred corpse. This sad cadaver.
Basically, what he'll let us do eventually is at Boss Souls. He is good thing for Boss Souls.
Now.
That's basically all he's there for, is using Boss Souls. Now, guys, yeah, I do want to say, but it is our time. I do want to say goodbye for this first episode. I will see you again on the High Wall of Lothric.